week's writing is complete bullshit. So I'm just gonna wing it, you know? Improv, yes? And I'm gonna need a minute. In the meantime, the next act.
In the sod, the race is soon beginning. My father bets the family fortune on a sleek brown horse. My father had a hunch, we gave him lunch so daddy could make a wager. Ma would scoff, she would scoff, hear her scoff, and they're off. Yeah, they're off. Heard like a four-letter word, and they're off. Tickets flung to the ground. The band starts to play as the horses go round. And they're off. Mommy sat and cried. Dad was unaffected. He said, have you ever had a better 2 minutes in the last 3 years? She said, well, Joe, the dumb horse lost. He said, sometimes joy has a terrible cost. I know that. We would laugh. We would sneer. We would scoff. And they're off. Yeah, they're off. Mommy's biting his neck as they roll in the deck. And they're off. There is blood on the ground, and the band starts to play as the horses go round, and they're off. Isn't life funny? People lose money and have fun. Betting, of course, is hell on the horses and on families where the betting is done. It's a joke to believe someone's won. All they did was fight. Plus they discussed the weather. My father bets the family fortune till it disappeared. We also laughed a lot. That was a thing I often forgot to mention. But it's true. Yes, it's true. It is true. And he's off. Daddy's off. We get letters from Maine where he tries to explain why he's off. What was lost was not found. The band starts to play as the horses go round.
There is blood.
costumes planned for the original cabaret, and they don't really work anymore, but Elizabeth and Zoe said I had to wear them, or else, so, newsies. Also, new set list. That was Jeremy Sonnabend with In They're Off from A New Brain. Next up, singing Someone Like You from the musical adaptation of the classic novel Jekyll and Hyde, please welcome Abby St. Amand.
Thank you.
tense backstage, but you know what's not tense? This next act. Our directors, Elizabeth Zeno and Zoe Armstrong, performing Close Every Door from Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. This one's Guys and Dolls, but frankly, I feel like I could fit into the background male ensemble of any musical that takes place in the 1950s, so take your pick. Yeah. Speaking of the 1950s, during which a lot of musicals take place, our next act is from Natasha, Pierre, and the Great Comet of 1812. Please welcome to the stage Ellie Hansen performing Charming.
Charmante, you are such a lovely thing. Where have you been? It's such I know no way. watch the eagle fly to the sun and wonder how he got to feel so free. If you ever have, you know your journey's begun. Hey, what have you got to lose, boy, when already we are lost in the wilderness? And where we are headed, boy, I couldn't even guess. But off we go without no warning, running as we hit the ground, where our future lies a warning, where our hearts are outward bound. Till one bright and distant morning, we may stop and look around, and there, in the wilderness, finally we'll be
Joseph in the Technicolor Dreamcoat.
Obviously. You know, if I had properly planned this out, I would have put this costume, like, three acts earlier when we were still on our Bible kick. But, you know, you do what you can with what you got. Anyway, speaking of our theme, and me totally not getting it wrong or anything, our next act is a little bit eager, and it's from the deepest, darkest recesses of the vault. In fact, I'll wager you've never even heard of this act before, because this is the world premiere of Becca Levine's monologue.
Levine.
Becca Levine's monologue. Spotlight for the SM. Performed by the writer herself, please welcome Becca to the stage for the third time. Woo!
Hello. I am a stage manager. Well, for this show, actually, I'm an actor. Actually, I used to be an actor. You probably wouldn't have been able to guess that if you'd seen me backstage, taking deep breaths and trying not to cry. But I made the decision to become one of the often forgotten techies without whom an actor would come on stage without lights, without sound, in a mismatched suit and tie. Of course, there are probably about one third of you who would leave a show and go, wow, I really liked the costumes, or the set looked so real, or even I really liked the monster growling sound. But I bet about zero of you would leave a show and say, wow, that was really well stage managed. I mean, how many of you even know what a stage manager does? Because I don't want you to tell me I did a good job if you don't even know what I did. It's different when it's the high school teacher who told me I'd be a good stage manager congratulating me after my first college show. Or the SM who made me who I am giving me flowers. Or even the producer who calls me kiddo, saying she'd love to work with me again. But I don't do all this for you, some faceless audience member. I do this so some very talented people can have their time in the spotlight.
a suburb I actually lived on a cul-de-sac. That's literally a road that goes nowhere. That's the definition of dead end. I said I can't wait to learn to do a three-point turn because I don't want to be here. For long years, I finished up with high school, graduated top of my class. Thank you. But in college, I discovered that devising my own major was a bureaucratic pain in the ass. I thought I'd recontextualize Sanclair, but could only register for first-year French. Well, you should have heard my mom when I dropped Le Bomb and said, I don't want to be here. No, I don't want to be here. And I am not a negative person. It's just I've always known that I have places to go, dreams to fulfill, and ideas to discover. They're just never where I am. So anyway, back at school, I waited 5 semesters till I could snag one of their random degrees. I moved down south because I heard everyone was hiring, and they were, at the Applebee's. They fired me like 3 weeks later. My sublet promptly, whoops, fell through. As I checked into a hotel, I said it's just as well because I don't want to be here. No, I don't want to be here. And I was not a negative person. So I packed up my bags, though I had no place to go. I opened a map and said, show me my future, because it isn't where I am. I finally got a job at some humdrum office, like everyone right out of school does. I sat in my cubicle every day, sending faxes, and that's what my life was. I moved back home and said to my parents, I know what I've got to do. Since I am a dork, I moved to New York. And I started grad school. I really don't want to be here.
Jagged Little Pill, or any contemporary music. Listen, they were bad costumes before I got the theme wrong, okay? And you know what? You know what? If it were up to me, I would have kept with the one outfit thing, but when I went backstage after that last time, Elizabeth and Zoe threatened to dock my pay, which is funny considering, one, I'm a volunteer, and two, I can't find my wallet. Anyway, you know, if I had known my set list was going to be on my arms, I would have worn a lot of less long-sleeve shirts. The Write Out Loud competition is a contest that gives the opportunity to up-and-coming musical songwriters to have their songs recorded and sung by Broadway professionals. Little Miss Perfect tells the story of a young overachiever who's struggling with her sexual orientation. Please welcome Claudia Gomes to the stage.
Straight hair, straight A's, straight forward, straight path. I don't cut corners. I make a point to be on time. choke. She braids my hair. I sit there blacking out for the first time. Next thing I know, I lose control. I finally kiss her, but oh no. I see a face in my window. Then my brain starts to go, no, 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 no. You can't risk falling off your throne. La, 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 love is something you don't even know. No, 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 no. You can't risk falling off your throne. La, 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 la. You don't even know. Rewind, induce amnesia. Deny the truth, it's easier. You're just confused. Believe her when she says there's nothing there. It's never worth it when you're little miss
Chaplain, you may think I'm rather small, 'cause the posh papers are falling at your feet. So go ahead and snub me, and don't return my call, and build your house on top of if I change the name of the person sleeping in your bed. What you gonna do when I tell the tale that makes the country turn its head? Just a little gossip and just a little lie. I'll simply say the little tramp is just a little spy. And what's he gonna do when it all falls down? Applause. You wave our flag and the country do when the country says, now get yourself out of here. What you gonna paint when you cannot paint the town? I'm gonna wipe the smiles from that famous little clown. And what you gonna do when it all falls down? And all the king's horses and all the king's men will never put poor Charlie together again. And what you gonna do when it all
at this point in the show that I'd love to thank our tech people who keep everything running smoothly despite certain complications that I'm no longer allowed to talk about because I went too overboard last time. So let's hear a round of applause for Alexa Prim, our stage manager, and A.G. Booth, who's back in the sound booth. Our second to last act is... Eli Humphrey performing Enlightenment from the musical Starring, which details the life and times of brothers Vincent and Theo Van Gogh.
Sparkles in my eyes still remain. I know there's more to learn. I know there's more to be. As all the rays of the sun shine beyond the sea, and every moment with the intent to find enlightenment. Teacher, and every day I inspire all my girls to challenge everything I say, to blaze the trail in their own way. With their minds, they'll push us into better times. They know there's more. There's more to be, but the restlessness they'll repress us.
emceeing a cabaret dressed as the MC from Cabaret. Well, you know. We made it to the end of our show, kicking and screaming and being threatened by our directors. Speaking of which, I'd like to say a big thank you to Elizabeth Zeno and Zoe Armstrong for putting this whole thing together and being so kind and understanding. She keeps looking at me. Anyway, our next and final act is from A Gentleman's Guide to Love and Murder, which details the chaos that ensues when a penniless clerk finds out that he's the heir to a wealthy family's fortune. Please welcome to the stage, and I once again have been your MC, Jeremy Sonnabend, Ellie Hansen, and Aslees Dubois singing I've Decided to Marry You.
Quick, into the bedroom. Shut the door. Be very still. Rendered me speechless. May I call you Phoebe?
Yes. What am I doing here? This could be dangerous if I'm discovered. Imagine the scandal, and I can handle the scandal so visible. I'll stay invisible still as can be. What's going on in there? I can hear voices. I recognize multi. What is that, a woman? And if that's a woman, then what is she doing here? Is it the cousin? I wish I could see. If it's that cousin, it might just be business. It's family business and none of my business. Why is she here in the home of the bachelor? Of course, one can point out that I'm here as well, but does she not realize the situation puts her reputation severely in question? The merest suggestion could cause a sensation, and I cannot hear which is hell.
You want to marry you?
I could go home.
I'll be scorned if I marry
you. I should go home.
Still, I decide to live my life and be a wife again. I'll believe her my life, sir.
I should be
all. After raping it quickly,
it
sir.
Makes me laugh.
There's nothing can
bend the will like half Castilian
men. And there's goodness to spare in this life. And a gentleness there in you.
Isn't she done?
You have taken a wounded bird and torn her out of
love. This is my eye. This is quite
conventional. Is it not?
Rather
turning the plot. And so will they be your fiancé.
Why don't you send the cab away?
Phoebe, darling.
I will call the stay. I think I'll cry.
What was that?
What was what?
That sound. Is someone here?
Oh, pay no attention. That's just my new manservant. He's finding his way around. I'll be with you in a moment! Wadsworth? Isn't this madness? Who could foresee how one trick of timing could ruin it all? One in the parlor, one in the bedroom, nothing between but me and a wall. Look at Phoebe, noble and pious, my esteem for her only grows. But when I am with Phoebe, I am on fire, thinking of Sibella, full of desire, passion, and dare I say it, love. But when I'm with Sibella, whom do I admire? None but Phoebe, perfect and lovely. Who couldn't love her? Heaven knows. Round and round and round it goes. How happy I'd be to be at your disposal, my darling. Of course I accept your proposal.
Now we should kiss.
That would be bliss.
Darling, but first I'll say this. I decided to marry you.
Phoebe,
I decided to marry you.
Sibella,
when the trumpet was called, fall and set me free.
Then again, the Sibella.
Yes, I decided to marry you.
I will marry you, Phoebe.
What would you have done to me?
Phoebe,
Auntie.
your gracious bestowment. Yes, Roger, I told you. I'll be just a moment.